Section 4 of the Advocates Regulation provides that an advocate shall not accept instructions from any person in respect of a contentious or non-contentious matter if the matter involves a former client. David Mpanga and Timothy Masembe, who are former lawyers to city tycoon SUDHIR RUPARELIA, have been barred from representing the Bank of Uganda that sued the business mogul. The head of commercial court, Justice David Wangutsi's ruling that was delivered by Registrar Lilian Buchana, disqualified the two lawyers, saying the lawyers are potential witnesses in the main suit, though the lawyers claimed they were representing Crane Bank and not SUDHIR as a person.
None of our partners and associates have ever been engaged or in any way executed any instructions for the applicant.
The ruling has not gone our way, and that means that we have to consider the standard procedure, which is if you're unhappy with a ruling, you can appeal. We're heavily inclined to appeal.
This implies that Bank of Uganda has to hire services of other lawyers to represent it in the main suit.
It might improve the speed and progress of the mediation process.
Justice always prevails in the end, and these conflicted lawyers, It's now in the open.
The ruling caused excitement to SUDHIR RUPARELIA, who hopes that he will be able to win the main suit. The main case is currently under mediation by the principal judge, Justice Yokoramu Bamwine. Bank of Uganda sued SUDHIR and his Mera Investments Limited on behalf of Crane Bank, which is under receivership of the regulator in the case involving purported 397 billion shillings fraud orchestrated in a commercial bank on a scale that has not been witnessed in the country's recent history. Bank of Uganda took over the management of Crane Bank last November, putting it under bankruptcy after establishing that it was over-leveraged. According to Bank of Uganda, Crane Bank liabilities exceeded its assets, rendering it insolvent and hence posed a systemic risk to the banking industry. On 27th of January 2017, DFCU acquired Crane Bank assets and liabilities following the conclusion of the purchase and assumption agreements with Bank of Uganda.